Good morning. It's Friday, October 26, 2018. I'm Russell, and this is Rocky Road Devotions, a few minutes of help for today's journey. Our devotion today is entitled, How Long? And our scripture is Psalm 34. I will praise the Lord at all times. I will constantly speak his praises. I will boast only in the Lord. Let all who are helpless take heart. Come, let us tell of the Lord's greatness. Let us exalt his name together. In Luke chapter 13, we find the story of a woman who must have suffered from a curved spinal column. That was the physical reality. The spiritual reality was that Satan had bound her. She was bent and bound. There was a lady like that in a church I served years ago. Miss Peggy had crippling arthritis. Her hands were gnarled and twisted, and she walked stooped over just like the woman in Scripture. And just like the crippled woman, Miss Peggy was a fixture at the church. But she also didn't let her physical condition get in the way of her spiritual nourishment. The ruler or leader of the synagogue was quite a different matter. The woman was powerless and faithful. The rulers of the synagogue were powerful and faithless. The rulers had responsibility for the widows, the powerless. Yet the chief ruler could only bring criticism for Jesus healing her. They kept their bylaws, but ignored the greatest commandment to love God and neighbor. When Jesus saw the pitiful condition of this woman, he had compassion on her. Something had to be done. So he initiated the healing. The woman didn't even ask. Jesus reached out and touched her. Let's consider the contrast of reactions to this woman's healing. The woman had been crippled for 18 years. When Jesus healed her, there was no doubt that it was the woman they'd seen each week at the synagogue. When this woman stood up straight for the first time in 18 years, it must have been quite a sight. Luke says that she glorified God. Can't you see it? Like days gone by when you might see someone running down a church aisle because they'd been tapped on the shoulder by the Holy Spirit. This woman lifted uncrippled hands and straight arms without pain for the first time in 2 decades. She didn't care who was looking. She sang hallelujah. Off key or on, it made no difference. And then there's the people. They rejoiced. I can imagine if Miss Peggy had suddenly gotten healed, it would have caused a revival at our church. And then there's the rulers. They simply got ticked. What a contrast. It just proves that control is power vested. These rulers, in charge of everything with the legal right to discipline and punish wrongdoers, were so threatened by the popularity of Jesus, all they could think of was the fact that he was breaking their rules. They didn't bring worship. They offered up no praise to God for his healing this poor sister of theirs. They could only think of how Jesus' popularity was growing and theirs was shrinking. In Matthew's Gospel, chapter 12, it tells us that it was right after this that they started to plot how to kill Jesus. Now, if you follow the timeline of Jesus' movements, this was the very last time Jesus entered a synagogue before going to the cross. It kind of makes the point about crossing that line once too often with God. There's a time when he finally says, okay, your will be done. And God finally washes his hands of trying to save you. For you today. So, this woman was healed on the Sabbath. Some big crime, right? There are abused and powerless people all around us in our communities. Our job is to look for them, to find them, and to heal them with the touch of Jesus. They're crying out in their hearts a phrase that's often repeated in the Scriptures. It's the phrase, the question, which is frequently on the lips of a sufferer, how long, O Lord? You chew on that as you hit the rocky road. Have a blessed day.